Here at the Georgia Tech Research Institute, we are developing a lot of new technologies to put in unmanned air vehicles. We recently did several flight tests down in Fort Benning, Georgia, where we had multiple unmanned air vehicles flying together, collaborating, negotiating, sharing tasks, flying in formation in an orbit, and we kept them separated by about 15 degrees, following one another, doing figure eights, having a trailer follow a leader, doing different maneuvers and showing that they could sense each other. And these were all done autonomously on the aircraft. The computer on the aircraft did all that processing for them by themselves. There's this trade-off in unmanned air vehicle systems called SWAP. It stands for size, weight, and power. So whenever you're out operating these vehicles, you have to do a trade-off of how big does the aircraft have to be to carry all of these sensors. Instead, if you have multiple vehicles, they can each carry different sensors or different payloads, and then they collaborate to use their payloads, but there's a much smaller form factor. There's multiple ways to use this technology and use this capability. There's military applications, certainly with the Department of Defense, but there's a lot of homeland activities that we can work on. So for example, if you have a forest fire and you wanted multiple unmanned air vehicles to start searching where one aircraft may see a small fire, it may call another aircraft over to confirm that it's a small fire and it's an escalating fire. Then you can call a third vehicle over and it can maybe drop some water on it or put out a chemical suppressant. So there's applications such as pipeline monitoring or power line monitoring or bridge inspection. We're looking at research for advancing agricultural robotics. For example, hyperspectral sensors to start sensing plant stress or drought conditions, where we may then choose to go and treat the crops locally instead of having to treat the whole farm. I think the future is really exciting because there's a lot that can be done with these kinds of unmanned air vehicles. Being able to get the operator out of the loop or the operator farther away from the danger is really a big payoff for everyone in society.